Hello, it's Mr. O'Mara here again, continuing our series of character archetypes. Now, recently we looked at Professor McGonagall from the Harry Potter series, and as you can see, she is a witch because she's dressed up as a witch, obviously, and she does magic and stuff. But this is actually not her character archetype, and we've talked about this before. You are defined not by how you look, but by how you behave, or how your behaviour is presented. And she's actually a mother archetype, but there is a witch archetype. So let's have a look at a couple of examples of this. Now, this is the witch from The Wizard of Oz, of course, you know, witch nose and green skin and so forth. Sometimes the witch actually doesn't have magical powers, although this particular one does, but you can just be the wicked older woman. And as you can see, they do have a kind of consistent look about them. Although she's actually this one from... Bellatrix Lestrange from the Harry Potter series is a little bit different in one respect, so we'll come back to her. So let's have a look at what your witch typically has. Typically she is old. She can go from being just a little past middle age to downright ancient, you know, unbelievably old. She is ugly. She is ugly within and she is ugly on the outside. She is not, by and large, beautiful. She is tricky. The wicked old lady cannot be trusted. She might offer you a tasty apple, but it's poisoned inside. She might offer you Turkish delight. She might offer to give you great witch riches. I was going to say witches. She probably is not going to offer you witches. But all of this is a trick. She is female, and she is destructive. There might be some cases where this archetype, they put a man in the part, but honestly, I actually can't think of any. We almost always throw this at women. And she's not just tricky, and she's not playful. She is downright destructive. She's evil. This is not a good archetype to be. And that's worth keeping in mind because sometimes she's not described as a witch, but as the evil stepmother. And somebody pointed out to me that there are a lot of stepmothers in stories where there aren't stepfathers because women used to die a lot during childbirth. So it would be reasonably common for men to marry again, to have somebody to raise their kids. And lots of kids would have this experience of this older woman coming in that they didn't like. So stepmothers get a very bad rap. I think it's actually a bit of a shame in stories that we so often make stepmothers evil. But, you know, it is one of the archetypes. That's not to say we should keep doing it, but it is. And it actually doesn't much matter whether she's magical or not. So that's a really common one, particularly in old fairy tales and stuff, but it still persists in modern stories. So there's a witch hysteria archetype, and I'll be back soon to talk about something, the male, almost equivalent.